Okay, ladies and gentlemen, today is the day. Right, Carol?
Right on.
She just finished screaming. She's so excited. but I'm picking Carol up from work, so her friend's picking her up here, or at the corner, which?
Yeah, the first one.
First gas station. And hang on. Turn in the corner. Craziness. So I have all day. I've done the vlog already, and I've exported it. And it's being uploaded to the YouTubes at the moment. I have to finish one other job, and then I've got the rest of the day to pack, clean the car, fill the car, and then I go down and pick up Carol, and then we're off. Cool?
Cool.
Sweet. Travel vlogs!
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I just wanted to share with you what's going on right now. Like I said earlier on, I got the vlog done first thing this morning, and then I worked on the Popeyes video, which I edited, uploaded, and launched at, I guess, 1 o'clock. And so now I'm just kind of going through my desk and trying to find anything that I could possibly use in Florida. One of the things is this camera. If I'm going to do a live show, this camera is like a really good camera. And so I'm just going to put that on the desk. This is all the stuff. Got my sandals. I still haven't packed yet. Oh, look at this. I was wondering where the suitcase was, and Carol's like, oh, I'll get it for you. So she got it for me. This ninja. Look at the ninja. Oh, what a ninja. He's a ninja. Gonna miss the kitties. yeah. So I'm also gonna bring my good camera. I'm gonna bring this. I'm thinking about bringing this. I should just bring it anyway. That's pretty much it for that. I have a little tiny tripod on here. And let me just take it off, then you guys can see it, because I don't have any fast mirrors around. So this is a little tiny tripod. It was in my drawer. And so I'm like, hey, that'll come in handy. I feel like emailing Carol and saying, left without you, sorry. That'd be mean. I'm getting a sore throat. Very disappointed in that. It looks like we have sunny skies, a little bit of cloud, a little bit of blue, and man, it looks nice out there, but it's chilly. Let's do a quick check, and then we'll have lunch. Yeah, -9. And yeah. Okay, so I have to finish packing up. I went ripped through this drawer to try and find like cable ties, like wrap up stuff, and because I got so many cables in my bag that they all get intertwined, and then you try to pull out one and you pull out 10, and so I need to get a nice little organization system happening. All right, so I'm gonna start packing up this stuff. It is 1:20, and well, yeah, the other thing is I almost thought I could get away with doing a cook and review, but that would have just really loaded me up stress-wise. And so, because I need to pack and I need to clean up my car, and there's a lot of things I need to do to get going to go to Florida, and trying to start cook and review would have just really crunched my time, because I don't know how long it's going to take me to put that together. So I just put everything onto a drive and put it onto the laptop, open up the program, or the project on the laptop, and then my laptop or in the timeline it tells me what artwork I'm missing, because I have to update my laptop a lot whenever I'm doing this situation. So I bring in the latest project, I guess the last one that we did, brought it in, open it up, says what's missing, and then I go back onto this computer and start dragging over all the missing files, so that when I'm in Florida I don't have to like rebuild things. So that's all done, so I'm happy about that. And yeah, so everything's good to go. Let's start going. Let's start moving. Let's start packing. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, hour one of our trip to Florida, and I forgot Carol. No, she's at work, so we gotta go pick her up. As you can see by this freaking weather, we're leaving at the right moment in time. I just worry about my kids. You'll be far away and helpless if something happens to them. In weather like this, we won't be around to bail them out.
Okay, so I'm going to go to the gas station first. I've got lots of time to get to Carol's school, but I want to get to the gas station, fill her up. That way we got a full tank. It will get ourselves into the United States on that full tank. Because it's only like, I don't know, 400 or 500 kilometers to Windsor. And I want to gas up in the States next. And right now I only have a quarter of a tank left. All right, are you guys ready? Set, go. Made it to the gas station. It is $4.3.
Whoa.
Nozzle. I cannot believe this weather. Wow. Insane. 3301. Let's go, people. Florida's waiting. Carol's in the car. We're all set up. First catastrophe of the trip. I forgot my extra battery for the drone and the charger. So if we're just going to the cottage for a couple days, I would have just got my shots and that's it. But we're going to Florida for a week. So yeah, that wouldn't have been good at all. So we just had to zip home. Unfortunately, we lost about an hour. About a half hour there, half hour back. It's now 5 o'clock. Actually, no, we only lost about 45 minutes. So, first stop is McDonald's. Tim Hortons. I'm gonna be using my coupons. I got 2 donuts and a coffee. So you can have a donut, I can have a donut. Carol made her own tea. And we're stuck behind another slow truck. Great. Ken Rage.
Relax, we're on holiday.
Hang
breathe
loose.
In. Breathe out.
Breathe out. Load gun. Release. All right, first stop, Tim Hortons. Tim Hortons. Do a large. Hi, I'd like to get a large double-double.
Yep.
Chocolate dip. And.
No, we don't have chocolate dip.
How about a cruller?
Honey cruller?
Yes.
Little?
And a honey timbit.
And a honey timbit, please.
Sorry, and a.
Honey timbit.
Sorry, we don't have.
Can I get a honey glazed donut?
No, we only have one. We only have one honey dip.
That's fine.
Yeah, that's good, thanks.
Yep, is that all?
Yeah.
Drive-thru.
Thanks.
It's a churro, right?
I said a honey cruller.
Yeah. And a timbit.
What?
And a timbit.
And a timbit.
Timbit just fell.
How much?
A timbit is $2?
No, there's no timbit. I didn't charge for a timbit.
Okay.
Wait.
So can I have the money back?
It's just a donut and a coffee.
A donut and a coffee and a Timbit.
It's the wrong one.
Thank you. There. Thank you.
The Timbit.
Well, the Timbit.
We didn't charge for the Timbit, sorry.
Where's the Timbit? It's in the bag?
No, it fell on the floor and that was our last one.
Oh, so yeah. We don't have any Timbits.
Pardon?
So no Timbit.
No Timbit.
Thank you.
Worst experience I've ever had with a Timbit.
What the?
Tim Hortons.
Okay, so it was a guy in training, no problem. And so I give him a coupon for a free coffee and a free donut. And he says, that's $2, please. I'm like, what? And then there was no real communication whether or not we
we're getting a Timbit or not. Carol just wanted one Timbit because it's half the calories of two Timbits. So, and then,
continue on the route.
Girl who was training him was trying to tell him what he put into the computer wrong, and that's why it came up saying that we owed him $2. And then I'm like, okay, where's our Timbit? Oh, it fell on the floor, and it was their last Timbit, and they dropped it. I'm glad they didn't give it to us.
Yeah.
thank you for not still giving it to us. I appreciate that. And again, you know, all the power to people that have to work in that industry, because I couldn't do it. I would be the worst drive-through person ever. It would take 2 months to train me, and the company would go bankrupt in the meantime. Anyway, okay guys, got the coffees, we're off. Tim Hortons, Extreme Pita. And I'm getting sicker as the hours tick by.
Sorry.
And, what?
Sorry.
Sorry what? Oh, yeah, Carol.
Was that a roll up the rim?
Carol got sick.
Was that a roll up the rim?
Oh, it was. It could have been a car. False alarm. It was, please play again. So it's 6:49. We have like 1,800 kilometers to go. To Florida anyway. But at least we can get t-shirts here. Well, the lineup for Tim Hortons is gigantic. So I'm gonna go check out. And of course Pita, Stream Pita's closed. Wendy's looks like it's got a small lineup. Let's get some Wendy's food. So I went with the spicy chicken combo. There it is. Doesn't look too happy. I've got the fries, drinks, and you went with the home style.
Yep.
We'll eat this up and then we'll hit the road. Dinner is all done. I did the dishes. Because I'm cool like that. Again, Wendy's makes the best spicy chicken sandwich around. If you're interested in knowing who makes the best spicy chicken sandwich in the fast food market. Where to? All right, 1,859 kilometers to go. My seatbelt's already on. Don't try and put it on again. You'll go into a time warp. So we'll get to Windsor and then we'll drive. It is.
Proceed to highlighted route.
Okay. Tell me what to do, hon.
Yep, 7:15.
It's 7:15 now?
Yep.
So 7:15, 8:15, 9:15. And then we'll probably drive for at least an hour into the States, so maybe Toledo.
Continue on route.
Okay, let's go.
Bye.
It is now 9:15, and we have just entered Windsor, and we have to go across the Ambassador Bridge into Detroit. And apparently there's a huge chunk of road area that is completely closed. So we have to detour around that. It'll take a few minutes off our trek. But once we get around Detroit and out of Detroit, then hopefully it's more smooth sailing. Ready?
Ready.
Let's go. They're closed.
Oh.
So we're at the border. I should have started timing it. So it was like, we've been here for at least 2 minutes. So it's 9:30 when we started. There's about three cars ahead of us. Couldn't see any signs for a Nexus line or lane. So again, another crossing that doesn't have a Nexus line.
Sorry.
Why should blow her nose right in the middle of doing that? It's beyond me. So Nexus isn't helping us whatsoever on this trip.
Well, at least there's only three cars in front of us.
Yeah, so I've been stuck behind more.
Could be worse.
Yeah. It is the beginning of a holiday, so... But yeah, definitely could be backed up over the bridge.
Yeah.
All right, wish us luck. All right, it is 9:35, 36, 37. So only 7 minutes that we had to wait. And... he asked way more questions than others.
And 500
other
meters,
guys.
Keep right,
again, there was
left.
Not. There was no.
Keep right, then turn left.
Okay. There was no Nexus line once again, and he just asked a lot of questions. And I shouldn't ask him questions. Oh, and Carol had her phone on, to just in case he asked what the address was. And he demanded she shut off her phone.
In 300 meters.
So he did not want
left,
her phone on, I guess,
left.
Because maybe he thought he was being recorded or something. So, again, I don't know the rules why they wouldn't want your phone on to a map showing you where you're going to be. Anyway, so, yeah, did he ask any? Oh, he just asked if we had any food, how much money we had bringing into the States, because you're not allowed to bring over $10,000 across the border. And we were good without the 10 grand, so. All right, next stop, hotel. So we are on 24, because there's a huge chunk of, a huge section of road that's closed. So we're like on the outskirts of, what's it called? Detroit, trying to make our way south on 24. And then we'll get back onto the main highway, I guess it's 75 south. And continue on our way. There's Tim Hortons. Alright, we're at exit 18 at a Pilot. The gas is 269 or unleaded. Well, that's diesel, sorry. Unleaded is 219. I'm going to try and pay with my Visa. I always forget you. Come inside. Remove card quickly. It's going to say one moment. You're a Canadian. Sweep? No, I don't have the sweep my card rewards thing. The pump should know I'm Canadian. Just buy my card. Remove nozzle. Insert into rectum. Okay, I was like, oh, don't talk like that. Begin fueling. Okay, this was the easiest. Oh, are we doomed?
Don't leave them.
Well, here we go. Wow, it's working. I love Pilot. Good gas station. Accepts my Canadian card. I'm so tired. Sorry about the wind, people. I apologize. Let's go into that store when we're done. You ready? Let's go. So 24, 25, 11 gallons receipt. I'm gonna move the car. I am not one of those people that just leaves the car at the pump while other people are trying to possibly use it. There's a Taco Bell here too. But I'm not hungry for Taco Bell right now. Let's go check out the store. Thank you.
What'd you get?
I got my most favorite snack, the Chex Mix.
You got it just because there was a stormtrooper on there, didn't you?
Yeah.
And she's like, as soon as she sees Star Wars stuff, she just buys it. Doesn't matter if she likes it or not. This is traditional Chex Mix, savory snack mix.
They did have, what I've never seen before, is a garlic one. I'll have to try that another day.
I'll open that for you. I got one of my favorite American chocolate bars, Baby Ruth. Ruth, baby! Chocolate. What movie is that from? You guys know. And then, of course, I got a... You could get two for $4, but I didn't want two. Just wanted one. So I think both of those two... I can't remember how much she said. It's like $6. Yeah. No, it was less than that. It was like $3-something, because she gave me $6 back, plus change. So there you go. $4 and change. All right. Ready to go? Uh-huh. I'll find a place that we're going to sit. So we're at 1,326 kilometers to go. And, yeah.
Maybe.
Oh, yeah. I just, right, yeah. It is 25 to 12. And we are in Findlay, Ohio, and we're going to be stopping at a, what kind of hotel was it again?
I don't
remember. Yeah.
A hotel.
I'll tell you in a minute, but we're just, Township Road 99, and we arrive in 650 meters, and we are tired. Now I remember, it was the Comfort Suites Hotel. Just park in the thingy. Just park anywhere. We'll just go in. Oh, I thought there was a spot.
Arriving at destination on right.
All right, this is starting off. We're in room 103. They're having some issue with the keys, so the machine that makes the key work in these kinds of doors isn't working. So there were like two full families ahead of us that had been here for like a half an hour already, and unfortunately the poor woman who's working here tonight, I guess the machine's broken, it's not putting the right data onto the card to let people into those specific rooms, so she's been running around trying to let people in with her MasterCard, well, not her MasterCard, but the MasterCard, you know what I'm saying? Anyway, so this room is freaking huge. The size of this mirror. You think they'd put two sinks in it, it's so big. Jeez, that's crazy. That's cool how they did that. Nice, nice touch. Mm-hmm. They added little touches that they do. Lots of towels. And check this out, people. I didn't ask for this, but we've got like a swimming pool. I'm surprised there's not a high diving board. That thing's massive. This is great. This is the kind of room I'd love to get into, going to like VidCon or whatever, because you can have a lot of people in here partying. Not that I party on the work things, but yeah, I don't want to look at our view. It's something like the highway or something, the gas station. But that's a great desk to work at. Unfortunately, I'm only gonna be here the one night. Look how big this freaking room is. Like, wow. Carol! I'm gonna have to text her because she's so far away, she can't hear me. Oh, even the decoration on the roof here. Just to break up the monotonous of the craziness, right? It's so big. Paul from Critical Age Japan did a really cool review of a Japanese hotel. I guess it was close to or in Tokyo. So Paul, if you watch this video, I hope you watch this video, put a link in your, like, leave a comment, put a link to that video in here so people can see the difference. I think his room was like this big. That's how big his room is, like from here to here to here, because it was like the bed and then the washroom was extremely tight. They could probably fit four bedrooms, maybe more, in this space. But this is America, so everything's big here. All right, time to brush teeth, go to bed. Long travels. See you tomorrow. Good night, Carol.
Night.
Night, people.